Hello, minions, and welcome back to Attack of the Bteam. As you can see, I am here in the Hall of Minions, and you will see why I've started here in just a minute. I had some good news. First of all, G-Funk, buddy, check it out. Your head is showing up now. Awesome. But I've got something else up my sleeve as a little surprise for you. I'm actually going to take your statue down there, G-Funk. And, yeah, just so you know, buddy, there, I noticed that you are doing an awful lot of sharing my videos and posting in the comments and giving me feedback and telling me which series are good and which ones are not so good. And, man, you're helping me out a lot, and you're giving me a lot of desire to keep this series up and make the Hall of Minions even more epic. So, what I have decided to do is I have decided to give you a Minion Prestige level. You are now Minion Prestige Tier 2, which means that you get to have your statue carved out of gold, buddy, for sharing my videos and doing all that cool stuff so much and so actively. I think you are an awesome guy. Thank you so much for enjoying my videos. If you were the only person watching my videos, buddy, I'd still be making them just for you. So, I'm gonna go ahead and come in here and I'm gonna type in G-Funk 609. And there's your skin, and look at you, you are made out of solid gold, buddy. Look at that, you're looking good, man. But I'm also gonna come in here, I'm gonna put your, see, where's your diamond helmet? Gonna put your diamond helmet back on. I'm also gonna give you a pair of diamond boots, brand new. Check that out. And finally, I made a very special token of my appreciation for you. I made you a special sword out of bronze, and it's called the Blade of Minion's Might. It is a special ceremonial sword given to you as a reward for being such a frequent subscriber and naturally such a devoted minion. So here you are, getting some recognition for your hard work in helping out on my series by sharing out my videos. And anybody who wants to be the next one to have their character carved out of gold in the Hall of Minions here, all you have to do is share my videos as much as you can, give me some likes on them, and let me know that you like them so that I know that I have a reason to, you know, keep making them. And G-Funk, buddy, keep up the good work. The other thing I want to say while I'm down here in the Hall of Minions is I had somebody else ask me to be in the Hall of Minions. Their Minecraft name is TySim10, and I saw your comment, and I replied to you and said that you would be the next addition to the Hall of Minions, so here you are! Check it out, I like your, I think you're supposed to be a bear? I like your skin, but I made you some wooden boots to go along with the whole natural bear woods thing, and I made you a sickle and a sword out of gold, so I figure you'd like that there. I spent a little bit of time getting you to look just right. G-Funk, once again, thank you, buddy, for watching my videos. I'm glad you enjoy them. You keep asking me, when's more gonna be out? Oh, man. Well, I'm making them right now for you. So, another thing that I wanted to show you was, oh, yeah. You may see. I'm gonna explain what's up with all this in just a second. The other thing that I wanted to show you is that I upgraded my Tinker's Construct Forgery just a little bit. I've done the following things. Right here is the smeltery controller, and that's what holds all of the materials that you're melting down and all of the liquid and stuff. And I have faced a regular vanilla Minecraft hopper into it and put a chest on top of that. So if I want to cook something, let's just come over here and grab whatever. Let's go with silver. So if I want to cook something, all I've got to do is put this silver up here in the chest, and it'll just be taken out one by one by this hopper and placed right in here automatically. So I don't have to worry about filling this up. I can just fill this chest up as much as I want with as many ores as I can, and it'll just put them in here for mass production. As you can see, it's still adding them in. But then the next thing that I also added was I added a little redstone circuit over here, which I will show you in a moment, And this redstone circuit puts out redstone pulses to these seared faucets and makes them pour automatically. And then underneath of the seared faucets, I've got a train of hoppers that all point into each other over to this chest. And basically, I've used this whole automated system to make all of these different blocks of materials. I've got 2.5 stacks of iron over here. I've got almost a stack of this aluminum brass, almost a stack of bronze, bunch of ferrous block, more than a stack of tin, some aluminum, lead. So I've got all sorts of stuff. And now that this is done and there's a bunch of molten silver in here, 128, I can come over here and I'm just gonna turn into a bat real quick because it'll be a little bit easier to show you what's going on here. So you'll see if I come over here and drop down this trapdoor, right here is where that lever is. So that lever right now is on and it is keeping this line on, which is keeping this torch off. You see, this line comes over here through these repeaters, it comes out here, and just up over to this. So it's just a little clock with these repeaters facing out, and if I turn this lever on, or off I mean, then what you'll see is that the clock is activated, and now I'm slowly, it's automatically pouring these. And as soon as they are full and the block hardens, as you'll see in just a moment way back there in the back, what happens is pretty much immediately it's sucked out by the hoppers and transported down the line and into this chest. So that is how that works. I think it is a brilliant system. I love the way I made it come together like that. Let's put this silver block up here. All right. So that's that. There's a little bit more that I want to add to it. I want to add another row of hoppers that actually goes into these, but I'm not sure how to do that yet. But I guess the next important thing to show you is what happened already. I was recording a video for you guys, alright? And this is such a tragic story. I was recording this video for you guys. I built for about 3 hours on video. And what happened at the end was I went to edit the episode and it wasn't there. So I built all of this and I don't have any of the footage from it. But if I just come up here to my nice takeoff point and jump off, you will see that I have done a lot of building. A lot of building. Do you realize this is like over 1,000 stone bricks here? And you were going to come along with me for that journey, and it was going to be all fun and cool and stuff, and it didn't quite happen out, didn't quite work that way. So, what I'm going to do in this episode is, with all of this nice building work done, and this whole area around here lit up, except for, I guess, right there, to where monsters don't spawn anymore, I'm going to show you how to use the, Mr. Crayfish's furniture mod and make yourself a bunch of custom furniture that you can use to spice up your area. So I'm gonna go ahead and activate my redstone entrance here, which I also built and you missed, but actually, I guarantee that Mike is gonna ask me how I did this, so I guess I'll show you real quick. You walk on this pressure, on this, what's it called? Tripwire. And it'll raise up the steps for you so that you can get up there. And if you don't raise it, you can't get up there because it's a block and a half jump unless you can fly like me. But yeah, and then you can just run up before it retracts. And the way that this works is over here, the end of the tripwire hook passes a redstone signal down here like this. It comes down here and around. By the way, this stone brick right here, that's the very top of the Hall of Minions. So it passes this redstone signal down here. Repeater passes the repeater on a maximum delay, passes the redstone signal into here, and that does two things. First of all, it turns off this torch, and this torch is on and powering this whole thing here. And that thing right there is actually, if I just come over here, that thing right there is turning off all of these torches that will extend the lower row of pistons. then as well at the same time, it also turns on this up here, which turns on the entire upper row of pistons. So really it's very simple. There's not a lot of complex circuitry or anything involved. It was just kind of weird trying to squeeze the project into the space that I had available. So let me go ahead and put the stone bricks back here and come over here. There we go. So what I'm going to do today is make myself some lights and some furniture and all sorts of other cool stuff. And maybe I should turn back into myself for this. Yeah, just like that. You'll notice that this is, formerly I had a farm back here. I have harvested the entire farm and removed it. I made all these doors out of ghost wood, which you can find in the Nether. So that's cool looking. All the food from the farm, everything on the farm is all in here. I found these hay bales out in the world, in these like structures that generate made out of hay bales. You'll notice that I have a different floor over here, and that's because this is gonna be the kitchen where I'm gonna like make all the food plus mod items, like a refrigerator and oven and the worktop and all that stuff for making myself some nice delicious food, because you know every growing mad scientist needs all his foods. You'll see that this is a tank from Open Blocks, and right now I've got it all of these like pretty much full to the top with XP. So if I stand on here, you'll see it drains my XP levels and it goes into the tanks here. So that's cool. Over here I've got all the witchery seeds. Over here I've got all the necromancy stuff, which I think necromancy might be my next video. And I have moved, let's see, so how'd this go? Alright, cool. So from doing that, just sort of walking away, I did end up with 13 blocks of silver block, and there's some extra in here which I'm gonna have to clear out. But overall, I think that's a really good way to like automate your Tinker's Construct stuff. That's really interesting. Over here, I've got a bit of a storage area, and there's a wall of furnaces here that I haven't really used very much. Although I do need these circuit plates from in here, which, yeah. Okay. And I'm gonna take those circuit plates, and they're gonna go in the redstone chest here, because I really needed them. Let's see, put this in here. Alright, and it looks to me like the next thing I'm gonna do is probably start making these lights. So there's two kinds of lights that I can make, and I think I'm gonna make them both. One is from Mr. Crayfish's furniture mod, and that is, let's see, I want the ceiling light, I think it's called. So let me just find that and see if I can find the recipe for it. No, that's not right. Let me search for ceiling. The I transposed the I and the E. Ceiling. There we go. Ceiling light. Mr. Crayfish's furniture mod. And if I look, the recipe for that is an obsidian, a stone, and a glowstone. So I don't actually want to make these yet. As a matter of fact, those are going to be saved for the next time, I think. Right now, what I know I'm going to make is these open blocks, or not open blocks, I mean to say, let's see, go into mods, come on, go into mods, and go to Project Red Illumination. What I want is these lamps. I think I want blue lamps everywhere. So if I just look up these lamps, lamp, like that. What I need for the inverted blue lamp is, whoops. What I need for the inverted blue lamp is two blue Illumars, a redstone torch, and a bunch of glass pane. This blue Illumar is made like this with two glowstone dust and two of any type of blue dye. And if I want to make blue Illumar, I can also use it to make, instead of just the lamps and the inverted lamps, I can also make lanterns, cage lamps, fixtures. So I think I'm going to use this kind of lighting system for my base here. And I've got some of this stuff here just ready for me. I've got what it takes to make one stack worth of this stuff. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. And then I'm going to grab some glass, which I think is in here. Yeah, I'm going to grab some glass. And I'm going to grab some iron. All right. I'm going to take this glass out here to the crafting table. And I'm going to make it into panes like what, this? Yeah. Okay. So I've made a bunch of glass panes now, and that's good. I want to use a bunch of iron as well, and I need to make a bunch of this. Okay, perfect. Now I want the uses for blue Illumar again, and what I want is some redstone torches. That's the only other thing I need. The circuit plates, redstone dust, cathodes, alright. So I'm gonna grab some redstone dust and these circuit plates and redstone torches. Come back out here and let's say I'm just gonna make 16 worth of the one, which is like this, right? Just like that. Uh-huh. And there. Yeah. Okay, so I've made 10 of that. That works for me. And then the other thing that I want to make is the cage lamp. Oh. Blue lantern. I need gold nuggets for the lanterns. Okay. So let's run over here and get some gold, which is very good. Aha! It's raining now, but guess what? It's not raining on my parade because I actually have a roof. Yes! Aha! Thank goodness. Okay, so I'm gonna come on over here with my gold blocks, make some gold ingots, make some gold nuggets, and come in here, and I make, let's see, I make this just like this, right? I need redstone torch, a gold nugget, blue Illumar, glass, and circuit plate. Okay, so I want some more glass panes, right? Okay. And the glass goes here and here. And the Illumar goes in the middle, and the torches go at the bottom, and this goes in the corners with gold nuggets on top. All right, there, I've made some lanterns now. Perfect. And the other thing that I wanted was the cage light. So let me just look at the recipe for that real quick. Oh no, that's not what I wanted to click on. Uses, all right. And that is iron bars at the top, gold nuggets in the bottom, Illumar in the center, and a conductive plate. And the conductive plate is made just like this. So next thing I want to do is make conductive plate. So I'm going to run back in here and grab myself some circuit plate. And let's see. Okay, just like this, I'll go ahead and put this away, right? Because I don't need it for this recipe. Gonna grab my sticks. Oh, no, wait. No, I don't need that, because I'm gonna make circuit plate. So if I just grab this and do this, I should be able to, yeah. Should be able to make some conductive plate, just like that. And then the conductive plate I will use like this. Where is it? Bottom, gold nuggets, Illumar, bars. Okay, so I want bars. Whoops. Works for me, whatever. Illumar. Darn. Need more gold nuggets. Okay, perfect. Just like that. And then Illumar in the middle, and then this stuff at the bottom, and then these all around edges, right, just like that, perfect, and pow. Yes. Oh, nuts. I wanted the inverted kind. Uh-huh. So what about the other kind? How do I do that? Uses. Cathode. Darn it. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and make cathodes then. And do the same thing some more, right? Yeah. So I'm gonna take these bad boys. Yeah, right, just like that. Put the cathodes down here. Oh no, wait. Some more gold ingots. Cathodes down here. That. All right. Perfect. So now I've gone ahead and made those. And I can bring my golden stuff back over here. My gold and iron, gold, put all that stuff in there. I guess I can safely put my redstone over here as well. Iron bars are gonna go over here in decorative blocks for decorating, just like this. They're gonna go right there. All these circuit plates and conductive plate and cathodes, all those, the extras for all those are gonna go right there. Although I'm gonna need some more. See, do I have more sticks? I need more sticks. Whatever. That's okay. So, what I want first is out here in the main room, I want to take out all these torches. So now I'm gonna hit F7. And what you'll see is this grid appears, and this grid is actually a grid of all of the areas here that can spawn monsters at the current light level. So if I just count here like this, let's see, let's just start here. This looks good. That looks like a good place to start. I'm gonna put one of these right here. Okay, wonderful. And then I want to put another one, like, right here. Let's see if that's good. No, see, I'm leaving too much open back here. So I'm going to pick this back up. All right, that's fine. Put my marble brick back down here, and let's try here instead. This is gonna leave me a little bit short. I don't think I have enough. Okay. Alright, so I am gonna put torches over here. But at least they're decoratively enabled. They look alright, is what I'm trying to say. It's not like torches all over the floor or anything, which looks ridiculous, and I don't like it anymore. Okay. Cool. So this works. And if I just start the next row, but that's only one row. I need to make at least another row worth. May have to gather some more resources and come back to this project, guys. So I'm gonna break that there. This here. And this here. One goes there. And I'm not done with this room. Ha ha. Okay, that's all right. I'll get back to it. That's fine. I'll do the other things today, too. Okay. So the other thing that I want is I want some of these lamps in here. So I'm gonna go ahead and turn into a bat. I'm gonna go batty real quick so I can hang up these lamps. Want one there, and I want one over here. All right, beautiful. Okay, I like that. I like the way that works. Uh-huh. Cool. So, that's good. Oh, nuts. Hey, yeah, it's raining, I know. Whatever. So, the next thing I want to do is I actually want to post up... Let's see. Is there anything out front that I want to... No, I don't want to hang these out front, I don't think. Okay. That's good for those. Let's do some of these inverted cage lamps. Uh-huh. I want these cage lamps up here. All right. I like the way those look. Yes. Now my details are getting much better now that I'm actually adding the right lights and stuff, so hopefully I should be able to reorganize these torches in such a way that it doesn't look horrible, which I think I'm doing an alright job so far. Yeah, alright, I like the way that looks. Let's go ahead and come on over here, go down. Yes, I love it. Yes. See, and then I want a lantern there, and I want a lantern over here. Okay, perfect. Just like that. I want. See, can I use these? The next question I have is, can I use these up here on the ceiling? Up my ceiling a little bit. Yes, yes, I can do that. Cool. All right, I like the look of that. I like the look of that. Let's come in here. I should be able to light this whole area with that. Let's see if I'm right. Okay, not that corner. Let's take out all these torches. Okay. Then I just want, let's see, I want one of these over my crafting station. I want one of these over here. Okay, let's just put this. Oh, man. Right here. Okay. Yeah, I like the way this looks now. I like the way this looks. Awesome. So the next thing that I want to do is I've got some wool here and I want to make myself a sofa for my lounge area. Okay, so I'm using this thing here now and I'm gonna take this wool and I'm gonna dye it black and I'm going to make a sofa out of it. So if I just look up the couch, I think it's called, is it a couch? Yeah, couch. Six, it's six black wool. I've got to have one more ink sack somewhere. Yes. Oh my gosh. How perfect. Got two couches in the works. And I make them just like this. Bam. Got two black couches. Gonna come out here. Alright. And I'm gonna make a couch. One couch here, one couch here. Alright, yeah. No. I don't wanna like that at all. Should I play some music? No. Can I sit on this couch as a bat? No, I can't do that. That's okay, I'm gonna sit on it anyway. Look at me. Ah! I'm sitting on the couch, everybody. Hovering over the couch, everybody. Yeah, I don't know why I'm doing this. Alright, so I made myself some couches, and I made myself some lights, and I'm not sure what else to do. This was really unexpected. I expected this to be like regular old episode, and everything went smoothly, but no, I lost 3 hours worth of video footage. So, what's something else that I could talk about? Oh, my Pokemon thing. Have you seen my Pokemon video yet? My Pokemon cubed version. I'm working with some custom NPCs mod and the Pixelmon mod and Mr. Crayfish's furniture mod, and I'm trying to make a brand new special region in Minecraft called the Uin region, and I'm working together with the creators of the original map, which is like a Pokemon-inspired map, although it's not meant to be like copying Pokemon locations, just inspired by their style and stuff. And I think it's really cool. If you haven't seen that video yet, you should check it out, because you're gonna be like, wow, you have done some cool stuff with custom NPCs. And custom NPCs is awesome. In fact, if you guys would like me to do like a review or a guide or tutorial or whatever for custom NPCs, just let me know, because I would be straight willing to do that, so you can learn how to make stuff as cool as what I'm making in that video. Other than that, I don't know that I have too much else for you today. I can try making some more furniture here, decorating a little bit more. Where is the furniture mod? Way down here. So I could make some, like, stone chairs and coffee tables and stuff like that, but none of this other stuff really applies to me much. Let me look at the recipe for this. Stone chairs made out of stone in a lowercase h shape. Okay. That's easy enough. So can I do it just like this, I think, right? Oh, yeah. So where's my stone at? Like this? No. Is it cobblestone? Well, that's cool. I never get to use cobblestone for anything. So grab some cobblestone and put this cobblestone like this. Oh, yeah, and I got myself 10 stone chairs. Woo! Chairs! Oh, yeah. Okay. So, let's see here. I'm going to put one chair right here facing into this work table thing. And I'm going to put some chairs out here. Let's see. I'm going to do over in this corner. Can I make tables? How do I make a table? Let's see here. Mod. Mr. Crayfish's furniture mod. And I make stone coffee table. Recipe like this. Okay, cool. Like a cobblestone helmet, basically. So I'll run in here and I'll grab myself some more cobblestone. I'll run out here and make it into a cobblestone helmet shape thing, just like that. Alright, and let's make a four table, yeah. Okay, that should do it. Alright. So, over in this corner, I want a table like this. Yeah, just like this. Okay, yes. Fantastic. That is amazing. Then, facing into this table, I want all my chairs like this. Yeah. Okay, beautiful. I can sit on these, right? No, I can't sit on these. Not as bad. I think if I morph back into myself, I'm pretty sure I can sit on these. So, go ahead and just become myself for y'all real quick. And, no, I'm still wrong. It's just furniture. Why can't I? I thought I should be able to sit on this. Isn't that right? Can I sit on them? Does it work like that? No, not. Apparently not. Apparently I cannot sit on those. nor these. So that's a little strange, I think. Doesn't seem like quite the way that it's supposed to be. I'm sure that's some sort of bug. That's okay. What about the TV? Can I make a TV? Uh-huh. Let's see here. Scroll down, TV. Recipe. So I need a standard wood, a glass pane, and a piece of redstone. Oh yeah, that's a piece of cake. I can make some of that just real easy. So let me grab some more stone table here. Yeah, this is what I should do. And also take my diamond axe onto my bar, and let's run out and grab some wood real quick. Yeah, so I'm gonna go ahead and go get some wood.
Let's see how I do this. Right,
like this, and this, and this. Right? Yes, TV. Made a TV now. So I've got some couches and a TV and a jukebox. This TV needs to go like here. Yeah, just like that. Oh, well, then. Okay. Thanks for that. I'm just gonna leave that exactly the way it is. I can't see any reason not to. I don't know what else to do this episode. I've got, in my next episode, I believe I'm going to take a look at the Necromancy mod, and I plan for it to be as in-depth and detailed as my previous mod on Tinker's Construct. I'm going to make some Necromancy things, or I might even do the Darwin mod, where I can breed some crazy stuff together and make cool, crazy hybrid mutant things. So, if you want, you can vote in the comment section down below on which one of those I should do. Or if you would like to be in the Hall of Minions, you can comment down below and share my video. And of course, make sure you're subscribed, because you're not a minion if you're not subscribed to Dr. Darok. So subscribe to my channel, share this video, and leave a comment saying that you want to be part of the Hall of Minions and have your Minecraft username on there, and I will be glad to add you to the Hall of Minions. I add somebody in every episode that I do of this series. So if you want to be the next one, get your name in there now. If you make yourself a compelling argument for why you should be the next one to be carved out of gold, maybe you can be carved out of gold. So thank you once again to G-Funk609, my most fervently working supporter, the best minion in the hall so far, and deserving of a special bronze ceremonial sword, new diamond boots, and a nice new golden body. Thanks for watching, everybody. Next time, Necromancy.